Hello everyone, I welcome you all in a virtual classes program of the Edgars International School, School at Home, Standard 6, Subject Mathematics, and I am your mathematics teacher J.M. Khan, and today we are going to continue our third chapter, that is playing with number. As I told you before, very important chapter as far as mathematics is concerned of higher level and higher classes, right? So in previous video we discussed divisibility tests, right? So today we are going to see more divisibility tests, like 7, as I told you. 7 is not included in our syllabus, but still we are going to look after 7, and after that 11. 11 is in our syllabus, right? So let us start with divisibility test of 7, right? What is the divisibility test of 7? For example, 49. Okay, you know very well that this 49 is divisible by 7, right? But if I write 3, 4, 3, if you want to find it out, that is it divisible by 3? Is it divisible by 7 or not? So how you will going to find out? By dividing it? No. If you want to find it out directly, so what you will do, you will cross this thing. Okay, just double it. Right, double it. 3 2s are 6, and add this 6 in this remaining part. 4 plus 6, subtract this part from the remaining thing. Clear? Take a difference of it. First, what you will do, you will remove a unit digit, then double it and take a difference of remaining part of the number and the double of first digit, right? So if I subtract it, we get 28. If the given number, if the result is divisible by 7, then the given number will also be divisible by 7. Here we can see 3, 4, 3, right? So is it divisible by 7? Yes. Let us check. 7 4s are 28, 6 then 3, then 7 9s are, okay, 7 49s are 3, 4, 3. Yes, it is exactly divisible. That's why we can say it is divisible by 3, 4, 3, and it is the divisibility test of 7. Hope it is clear to all of you, and you all will practice it. Okay, so I am just taking one example of it. Okay, you can practice it because it is not in our syllabus. I am just giving you idea. Let us discuss divisibility test of 11. Right, divisibility test of 11, here we can see divisibility test of 11. So what is the divisibility test of 11? For example, I'm writing over here 1 2 1. Is it divisible by 11? Okay, you know very well 22, 33, 44 and 66, 77, 99, right? And 110, these are divisible by 11. But how to check this thing? Okay, so what we are doing, we are taking alternate numbers, right? What we are doing, we are taking alternate numbers. Okay, first 1 plus 1, this is alternate, 1 plus 1, then here alternate is only 2, that means 2, and we are taking difference of it, 2 minus 2, 0. If the difference of sum of alternate number, what difference of, here is a different difference means sorry, difference means subtraction, we are subtracting in it from it. Okay, so if the difference is divisible by 11, 0 is divisible by 11, 0 is divisible by any number, we can say. Okay, so if the result is divisible by 11, if the difference of sum of the alternate number of the given number, alternate digit, sorry, difference of alternate sum of alternate digits is divisible by 11, then the whole number will be divisible by 11. Okay, take a screenshot if you want to, but next example will clear this idea for you. Okay, I'm taking next example, that is 61809. 6 1 8 0, 9. So I am taking alternate number, right? Here, 6, 8, 9. I am adding it. Sum of alternate digits in a number. 6 plus 8 plus 9. Okay, 9 plus 8, 17 plus 6, 23. Right? And here we have alternate 1 plus 0. That means 1. So, difference of this, 23 minus 1 is equals to 22. Is 22 divisible by 11? Yes, 22 is divisible by 11. That's why we can say 809 will be divisible by 11. This is the divisibility test of 11. Clear? One more example I am taking here. 1331. Now pause video and solve it. Okay, and now check your answer. So here, alternate digits we are checking. 1 plus 3, 4, 1 plus 3, 4. Here, 4 minus 4, how much? 0. 0 is divisible by this. That's why it is also divisible by this thing. I can tell you one more thing, one easy part. Okay. So, hope you got this thing. But I have one more trick. It is not in your book. So, let us proceed to that trick. Okay. Here we have that trick. 121. Right? What you will do, you will subtract this digit from the remaining one. From the remaining thing. What is the last one? Okay, it is second method. Huh? Second method. First, you got it. Okay. Second method of divisibility test for 11, right? So, 12. What I will do? I will just cross this thing, unit digit, and I will subtract this one from remaining. Okay. So, remaining is 12 minus 1, that is 11. If the remaining thing is divisible by 11, so the whole number will be divisible by 11. Okay, now if the number is bigger, so how you will do it? Check this out. The previous number, previous example that I have, we have taken 61809. 61809. Now check this out. See, cross 6180 minus 9 is equals to how much? 6180 minus 9, 71. Right? Then again, I am subtracting this one. Now it will this process. See, it will be similar if I am dividing this thing from 11 by 11. It will take long. So this process will continue. Then again, I am repeating the same procedure. I am just cancelling this last digit, okay, unit digit, and again I am subtracting it from the remaining part. 617 minus 1, it will be 616. Clear? Okay, now again I am repeating same thing. Last digit, I am taking it out, and the remaining part is 61. 61 minus 6 will be equal to 55. Now you can see 55 is divisible by 11. So if it is divisible by 11, then the whole number will be divisible by 11, we can say. So here the proof is for the second method. What? Just eliminate last digit, right? So I am sweating too much here because I am not able to turn on fan and cooler because due to the noise, for the noise reduction in our video. So don't mind it. Okay, so here, clear? This is our second method, and see, just observe both the method to find out divisibility test of 11 and adopt whichever you want. Okay, we need precise answer only. That's it. Clear? Just take a screenshot of it, and if you want to write it, just pause video and write it, And now we are proceeding to our next exercise. Now we are done with divisibility test. Now we are proceeding with our exercise 3.3. Right? So in our 3.3, our first question is, give me a second. Okay. Using the divisibility test, determine which of the following number are divisible by 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11. Say yes or no only. So table is given over here. Exercise 3.3, we are going to start right now. And the divisibility test, yes or no you have to write. By 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 8, 9, 10, 11, 8, 9, I think this won't be sufficient enough for us, so I am taking here, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11. Only yes or no you have to write, right? So first is given, first is 128, right? This is example given over here, 128. So I'm not going to solve that 128, okay? 128 is already given, so I am starting from 990, right? So here, let us start with 990. Okay. Clear? Now, 990, is it divisible by 2? How can I say? Check unit digit. Is it divisible by 2? Yes, 0 is divisible by 2, so we can say yes. Now, is it divisible by 3? Let us check the sum of the given number, all the digits is divisible by 3 or not. So, 9 plus 9, 18. 18 plus 0, 18. 18 is divisible by 3, so we can say yes, it is also divisible by 3. Now, I will write yes, y for yes and n for no. No for n, okay, whatever it is. So, is it divisible by 4? So, I will check. Last two digits, right? So if I am dividing this 90 by 4, 4 twos are 90 by 4, 4 twos are 8, right? And 1 4 twos are 8, remainder 2. No, it is not exactly divisible by 4, so no. Okay, is it divisible by 5? Yes, 0, 0, 0 or 5. If there is 0 or 5 in unit digit, so we can say yes, it is divisible by 5. Okay, so is it divisible by 6? If both the places, if at both the places it is yes, so I can write yes over here, otherwise no. If both are yes, if it is divisible by both 2 and 3, then only yes. Yes. Is it divisible by 8? So all the 3 digits we have to check, and now I am checking 90, 990 by 8, 8 ones are 8, 19, 8 twos are 16, 3, 0, no, it is not divisible by 8 completely. Is it divisible by 9? 9 plus 9, 18, sum is 18 and sum 18 is divisible by 9 exactly, so yes. We can say yes, it is divisible by 9 exactly. Yeah, now 10. Is it divisible by 10? Yes, unit digit contains 0, so it is also divisible by 10. Now, what can I say? 11. Is it divisible by 11? So, I am seeing here, alternate digit 9 plus 0. How much? 9 plus 0 is 9. Minus 9, 9 minus 9, 0. So, I can say yes. It is also divisible by 11. So hope this is clear to all of you how we are doing it. Table is quite simple to solve because we can get hint from here. For example, 6 if we want to find out 6, we need to check just yes or yes. That's it. Okay, next thing is given 1586. 1586. Okay, 1586, we need to check over here. Now, 1586, is it divisible by 2? Yes, because 6 is there, even number is there. So, 1586, yeah. Okay, now, is it divisible by 3? Let us check. 5 plus 1, 6, 6 plus 6, 12 plus 8, 20. 20 is not divisible by 3, no. Then 86, 4 2s are 8, and then 6, 4 1s are 4, carry remainder 2, no. It is not also, 86 is not divisible by 4, that's why 1586 is also not divisible by 4. 5 here, there is no 0 or no 5, that's why it is also not divisible by 5. Okay, here it is not divisible by both 2 and 3, that's why we cannot say it is divisible by 6, then it is not divisible by 6. Now 8, let us check for 8. Okay, so for 8, what we can do here? Let me erase this thing. Question number 1 is started. We started question number 1 of exercise 3.3. I hope it doesn't matter if I rub it. 1586 divided by, sorry, only 3 digit we want now. 8. So 8 sevens are 56. Right? Then 26. Is it divisible? 8 threes are 24. 2 remained. No. It is also not divisible by 8. Right? Now, what is next? 9. So let us check for 9. What is the sum of it? It is the sum of this thing is 20. 20 is not divisible by 9. So no. We cannot find 0 here. So no. So let us check alternate digit. 1 plus 8, 9. And 5 plus 6, 11. 11 minus 9, 2. 2 is not divisible by 11. So I am writing here no. Clear? I hope this is clear to all of you. How I am doing this. So next thing is 275, right? So yes, 275, how I am going to do it? 5 here in unit digit, 5 is there, 5 is odd number, so it is not divisible by 2. Now 7, 5 plus 2, 7 plus 7, 14. 14 is not divisible by 3, so no. Last 2 digit, 4 1s are 4, remainder 3, 35, no, 35, it is also not divisible by 4, 5, so is it divisible by 5, yes, the unit digit contains 5, that's why 5 or 0, if 5 or 0 is there, I can write, I'm making it little fast, okay, because now we are used to of it, okay, so now 6, for 6 we need 2 and 3 both, yes. So here we have no, so here also we'll write no, right? For 8, all the 3, 275 divided by 8, all the 3 we have to check. 8 3s are 24, 3 5. No, 35 is not exactly divisible by 8, so no, I am writing over here. The sum of this is 7 plus 7, 14, 14 is not divisible by 49, that's why no. Here we do not have 0 over here at unit digit, you can see it is 5, so it is not divisible by 10. Now 2 plus 5, 7, 7 minus 7, 0, right? So 0, 0 is divisible by 11, yeah, we can say yes, it is divisible by 11. Okay, so here we are done with we are done with only 3 and 1 2 3 4 5 6 6 question of a table, first table is remain. So these 6 question of table you have to do by your own. Okay, if you have any query you can ask me by in our interactive session or by using WhatsApp. Okay, so the further things we will discuss in our next video. that is a remaining part of this exercise 3.3. Okay, till then stay safe and keep practicing of mathematics. Thank you so much.